I'm Lin Xiaoen from Tsinghua University. Today, I will introduce the paper Improved Preimage Attacks on Three-Round Keccak with Parameters of 224 or 256. My presentation includes four parts: the research problem, related work, methodology, and conclusion. In the first part, I will show the background of the research problem, including hash function and Keccak. In the second part, I will introduce Guo et al.'s linear structure and Li et al.'s allocating approach. In the third part, I will introduce two techniques proposed in this paper, namely iterating strategy and 5-for-3 strategy. In the last part, I will conclude our work. It is expected that the complexity of pre-image attacks of three-round Keccak with parameters of 224 or 256 will be decreased to the 32 or 65 power of 2. First, research problem. Hash function is an algorithm which takes arbitrary length messages as input and outputs a fixed length digest. It has some properties such as efficiency, pre-image resistance, second pre-image resistance, and collision resistance. In this paper, we mainly focus on the second one, pre-image resistance. Pre-image means for a given digest, we want to find a message such that its output is the given digest. Pre-image resistance means it is hard to get the pre-image. To attack our analysis, we try to make it outperform exhaustive search in finding the pre-image. Keccak, which is chosen as secure hash algorithm standard, is an important hash function. Keccak adopts the sponge construction. It absorbs the message by every R bits and squeezes the inner state to get the digest. After absorbing a message block, the inner state is confused with Keccak F permutation. The inner state of Keccak F has B bits, which contains R bits rate and C bits capacity, where C is twice as many as N. In this paper, we mainly focus on Keccak hash function with parameters B equals to 1600 and N equals to 224 or 256. The 1600 bits inner state can also be represented as 25 64-bit lengths or 64 5 times 5 slices. The Keccak F permutation consists of 24 rounds of round function. Due to the high security of Keccak, we focus on the Keccak hash function, which is reduced to 3 rounds in this paper. Each round consists of 5 operations: zeta, rho, pi, chi, iota. In the first step, every bit is added with 2 columns. In the second and third step, it confuses the inner state in each lane or slice. These 3 steps are all linear operations. The fourth step is the only nonlinear operation in Keccak F permutation, where every row is transformed by a quadratic S-box. The last step is adding a round constant in the first lane. Then, related work. In 2016, Guo et al. Put forward a technique named linear structure. The main idea is that by setting some bits as constants and adding some linear equations, the first 2.5 rounds will be linear. Accordingly, part of the digest can be restricted by adding some linear equations. After that, the message can be obtained by solving linear equations, and the pre-image will be obtained if the rest bits of output digest are satisfied. Some details are shown on the picture. The inner state is denoted by the squares of 5 rows or 5 columns. Each square represents a lane that is 64-bit. The white square means the 64 bits are all zeros. The black square means the 64 bits are all ones. The gray square means some of the 64 bits are ones and the others are zeros. The yellow square means every bit of the 64 bits is a linear combination of variables. Besides, Guo et al. Set some restrictions on the first round and the second round before SATA operations by adding some linear equations so that the sum of each column will be constant. According to the operations of Keccak-F permutation, the inner state will develop as the picture shows. After that, the rest degree of freedom will be used to restrict some output bits to match the digest. As a result, we can get preimage by solving linear equations and check the digest repeatedly until all the output bits are matched. In 2019, Li et al. Put forward a new linear structure. The new linear structure has more variables and there are more degrees of freedom left. However, the starting inner state is not legal if there is only one message block involved in this linear structure. To meet the restrictions of the starting inner state, they add another message block before, and a two-block model named allocating approach is proposed. In the first stage, they use Guo et al.'s linear structure to get an inner state meeting the restrictions. Based on this inner state, they use the new linear structure, which has more degrees of freedom, to get the preimage within lower complexities. Note that there is a trade-off between the two stages. The complexity of solving the second message block is lower than that of solving the first message block. By meeting fewer restrictions, the complexity of the first message block can be decreased while the complexity of the second message block will increase. To sum up, there are two kinds of linear structure. Guo et al.'s linear structure can be used as the first message block, but it has fewer degrees of freedom. Li et al.'s linear structure has more degrees of freedom, but it needs to meet some extra restrictions in the starting inner state. And the more restrictions the starting inner state meets, the more degrees of freedom will be left. Next, methodology. In this part, I will introduce two techniques proposed in this paper to improve the preimage attacks. Specifically, these two techniques improve the first stage of the previous preimage attacks. One technique is iterating strategy. In the et al.'s two-block model, many degrees of freedom in the second stage are underused because of the unsatisfied restrictions. However, the first stage doesn't have enough degrees of freedom to provide a better inner state. In fact, the linear structure used in the second message block is able to provide more degrees of freedom. Therefore, we extend the first stage to more than one message block. In other words, we don't spend the degrees of freedom in the second message block matching the output bits directly, but we spend them restricting more restrictions as the first message block does. With a good starting inner state, it is faster and more likely to generate a better inner state. Iteratively, more and more restrictions will be satisfied. After a good enough inner state is found, we construct the last message block matching the target output bits as they do in the second stage, and we can get the entire pre-image eventually. This strategy can be used in both three-round Keccak with parameters of 224 and 256. It improves the first stage of the previous work by using multi-message blocks instead of one message block. Using this strategy, the inner state will be optimized gradually and reach a good enough inner state eventually. Another technique is 5-for-3 strategy. The purpose of the first stage is that the inner state can meet as many restrictions as possible. In previous work, they spend every 4 degrees of freedom in meeting 2 restrictions in both 2 parameters of Keccak. However, when applying to 3-round Keccak with parameters of 256, it is possible to spend every 5 degrees of freedom meeting 3 restrictions. The linear equations are shown as follows. In the previous strategy, they add 2 linear equations to fix 2 bits to arbitrary constants. After that, 4 bits will be linearized and the 2 linear equations can be added to meet 2 restrictions. Note that the freedom of arbitrary constants is underused. And by observation, we find that if we fix the 2 constants to both 1, an extra linear equation can be added to meet the third restriction. Therefore, it constructs a 5-for-3 strategy. This strategy can only be used in parameter of 256. When restricting the inner state in the first stage, it spends every 5 degrees of freedom satisfying 3 restrictions, which is more efficient than the previous work. As a result, more degrees of freedom will be saved. The table shows that the 5-for-3 strategy has a big advantage than 4-for-2 strategy in finding a good inner state. The experimental results of finding a good inner state are shown as follows. We can find that the inner state is getting better and better. At last, we find an inner state meeting 171 restrictions. Last conclusion. In this paper, we proposed 2 techniques named iterating strategy and 5-for-3 strategy. Iterating strategy uses multi-message blocks to provide a better inner state with more degrees of freedom. 5-for-3 strategy can satisfy more restrictions within the same degrees of freedom. As a result, the complexity of pre-image attacks on 3-round Keccak with parameters of 224 or 256 can be decreased to the 32 or 65 power of 2. However, it is noted that our techniques are still far from threatening the security of other Keccak variants or more rounds.